Please be seated. Good afternoon, and welcome to the 100th commencement exercises for Highland Park High School. We would like to thank our orchestra director, Mr. Tom Gutierrez, who's retiring this year after 36 years of service to Topeka Public Schools, and Mr. Chris Reynolds, our band director, for our prelude selections. We would also like to thank James Williamson, our bagpiper, and Jerry Anderson, our organist, for the beautiful accompaniment to our processional. Please listen carefully as I share this information with you. In accordance with the Kansas State Fire Marshal regulations, we request that you take a moment to identify the two emergency exits nearest you. We have checked these exits and the other emergency equipment in this building and verify they are available for use in case of an emergency. In case of an emergency, please pay close attention to the announcer or your usher for important life safety information. At this time, we ask that you please stand for the presentation of the colors by the Highland Park High School Junior ROTC Color Guard under the direction of Colonel William Deed and Sergeant Fernando Adams, and then for the singing of the Star Spangled Banner by the Highland Park High School Concert Choir under the direction of Dr. Patrick Katinda. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. you. Please be seated. At this time, the Highland Park High School Concert Choir will perform Seasons of Love. Thank you, Concert Choir and Dr. Katindo. I would now like to introduce to you Dr. Julie Ford, the Superintendent of Topeka Public Schools for her greetings. We congratulate Dr. Ford on her many years of service to Topeka Public Schools, her notable accomplishments, and her upcoming retirement. Dr. Julie Ford became the first female superintendent of Topeka Public Schools when she began her duties as interim superintendent on July 13, 2011. She previously was with the Kansas State Department of Education as Director of Title Programs and Services, where she has been in charge of district and school improvement. Dr. Ford has been in education for more than 30 years. The majority of her career was in Garden City, Kansas, where she served in many positions, exiting as deputy superintendent. She has served as superintendent, area superintendent, and director of curriculum and instruction in diverse school districts in Texas, Colorado, and Oklahoma. Dr. Ford received her master's degree from Fort Hays State University and her doctorate degree from Wichita State University. Dr. Ford has been married to John for 35 years, and their three children, Lyle, Megan, and Mitch, all attended Washburn University. It is my pleasure at this time to introduce to you Dr. Julie Ford, Superintendent of Topeka Public Schools. Dr. Ford.
Congratulations, graduates of 2016. This is your day. As we begin our graduation, let us reflect on the things that we are grateful for today. For the opportunity to graduate from a high school in Topeka Public Schools, the sixth largest district in the state that has such a rich history. Our district celebrates diversity, and this will prepare you well for success in college, technical school, military, and the workplace. For the fact that the Board of Education has focused not on a single test score, but on a well-rounded education, which includes fine arts, sports, technical classes, and student activities such as debate, forensics, ROTC, and multiple other activities that are great for students. For the opportunity to graduate from Highland Park High School and be in the 100th graduating class, with supportive alumni not only in the city of Topeka, but all over the world. You are graduating from an institution which includes such famous graduates as Ron Evans, astronaut, Aaron Wilder Domes, federal judge, and Michael Wilhoit, currently with the San Francisco 49ers and starring in the Super Bowl. For the excellent teachers, let me say that again, the excellent teachers. For the support staff and the administrators that have invested their time, their talents, and their love to assist you in reaching this goal today. For your parents, guardians, family members, and others in your life that celebrate with you today on your graduation day. And finally, for the supportive Topeka community that believes in our public education system in Kansas, even though each day it is being challenged. But they have done this by demonstrating their support for you by passing a bond issue that enhances our educational opportunities for students, such as being the first district in the county to have a one-to-one computer initiative, plus to enhance our safety in all of our buildings across the district. Last year, our community also supported Topeka Public Schools by approving an LOB election, which could help in the district in the future during these very stressful economic times in the state of Kansas. Gratitude is one of the life skills that will serve you well in your future. By practicing gratitude, it will enhance your health, it'll improve your relationships, and it also will strengthen your productivity. I personally am grateful for the opportunity to be the superintendent in Topeka Public Schools these past 5 years. And I've enjoyed the opportunities and relationships that were presented to me as I served this district. Never forget where you came from. Be grateful for the opportunities that you have had, and always keep your eye on your future dreams. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ford. This year marks a landmark year, one in which we celebrate 100 years of graduates from the greatest school in the nation, in our opinion, Highland Park High School. In recognition of this centennial group, we would like to introduce to you two individuals who represent the oldest living graduates of Highland Park High School. They are a delightful couple whose love and laughter has helped them weather many of life's storms to be here to greet you today. They are Dean and Maxine Horton. And Mr. and Mrs. Horton still live just a few blocks from Highland Park High School. So we're going to represent either one of them or both of them to come and say a few words of congratulations to you.
I want to congratulate all 205 of you graduating from Highland Park High School. I graduated in 1942, but my school that I graduated from was on 27th and Indiana. But you've graduated from a great school, and I'm proud of you.
Thank you, Mrs. Horton. Our first set of speakers is Ms. Heather King, our valedictorian, and Ms. Angel Allison, our salutatorian. And they will share with you in that order their own reflections as students at Highland Park High School. Ms. King is going to come first. While at Highland Park High School, Heather has participated in theater, math club, choir, parity club, band, Scholars Bowl, Send Scots to Scotland, Book Club, Air Force Junior, ROTC, Straight from the Pipes Literary Magazine, and the Gifted Program. She has had many achievements during high school, which include Kansas Governor Scholar, Kansas State University Dean's Award, Young Scholar Recognition Award, Top Scholar Award for 4 years, Academic Recognition Certificate for 4 years, Academic Excellence Award for 4 years, Highlander Award for 4 years, Pitt State Math Relays Participation Award, Kansas Honor Scholar, Emporia Math Competition Placement Award, Pitt State Math Relays Participation Award, American Veterans Medal, Certificate of Character Award, and she is also a member of the National Honor Society. Heather has also been active in the community by volunteering with Ad Astra Theater, Florence Crittenden, KC Friends of Alvin Ailey, Theater Department Cleanup, Topeka Civic Theater and Academy, Highlander Community Project, and many other activities with Air Force Junior ROTC. And following graduation, Heather plans to attend the University of Kansas, pursuing a double major in English and computer science. At this time, Heather Murray King.
Hello. Today we say goodbye. We say goodbye to our school, teachers, friends, and childhoods. I am honored to be your classmate. I am honored to have grown up alongside you. I think that there is no class that better embodies the spirit of Highland Park and fit to be the 100th than ours. You are all the most stubborn, loud, and unified students that I have ever encountered. And I think that that is great. Every one of us is stubborn, or rather persistent. Once we set our mind to something, there is no use trying to fight it. We place goals, and then we achieve them. As simple as that. We wanted a day together as a class, and so we convinced the administrators to host a senior cookout at Lake Shawnee. We needed money for college, so we earned over 460,000 in scholarships, which is more than the past two classes did. We're positively stubborn as a mule. We're also loud, not in a senseless way, but rather in a way that rises above the noise and holds power. Even our quietest members have fought to have their voices heard, and we've put that volume to good use. We've used it to lead. Since our freshman year, we've been heavily engaged in extracurriculars and working to make them better. We've continued legacies. Our basketball teams continue to enter state tournaments. Our journalism staff traveled to our nation's capital. And our theater department performed in the biggest arts festival on earth. We've revamped programs as well. Our choir department saw an opportunity with the incoming choir director our freshman year and completely reconstructed the program, earning higher scores and more members each year. Our band department has also grown in these past 4 years, earning higher scores at contests and even managed to get great uniforms this year. We've even started some brand new programs. Anime club, math team, bowling, and key club are just a few of the many examples. We've never been afraid to take charge and try and make a positive change. But most importantly, we are a unified student body. We don't all like or even know each other, but there was a familiarity between all of us. In the stereotype of high school, there are the jocks, the nerd, and the artsy weirdos that make up the three bodies of any school. In this stereotype, these factions never interact peacefully and definitely don't overlap. But here, they do, and they always have. No such lines are drawn between the students. We have friends from outside our main social circle. We even have a lot of kids who fit all three, like Chris, who does wrestling, math team, and choir, or Nathaniel, who does baseball, scholars bowl, and theater. O'Shaughnessy, our student body council president, who throws a shot put farther than any other goal in Topeka. I just think that it is important to point all of this out now while everything is so fresh in our minds, because soon the details will begin fading away. We'll forget the subjects of Mays Bogle's eccentric lectures and the origins of inside jokes. We'll forget teachers, events, and even some friends. One day, it will just all be a collage of memories that builds up to a general feeling about high school. And that's okay. You're not meant to live in the past. You shouldn't dwell on your high school years as the best time of your life. This is a milestone in your lives that should be celebrated, but it isn't going to be the best moment of your life. You're going to have bigger goals after this that you'll pursue and achieve. And then bigger ones after that. This isn't the end all be all. You have plenty left to look forward to. If nothing else, I ask you to please remember one thing for me. Remember the bad times. Remember the good times too, of course, But more importantly, remember the bad times. When you were furious, depressed, or exhausted, remember that. Remember all the times you thought that your world was going to implode. Remember that it didn't. That despite it all, you overcame it, and now you're about to walk across the stage. The Highlander spirit you have will take you far. So when you encounter obstacles in life, which you will, remember that you've already survived beyond the end of the world a few times. You've proven yourself before, and you'll do it again. Do not throw away your shot. And remember, it's great to be a Scot. Peace.
Thank you, Heather. At this time, Angel Allison is going to come forward. Angel is our salutatorian. While attending Highland Park High School, Angel has been very active in volleyball all 4 years and math club for 1 year. She has had many accomplishments, including being on the honor roll all through high school, earning Top Scholar Award, the Academic Excellence Award, the top 10% of her class, the President's Education Award for Outstanding Academic Excellence, and she is also a member of the National Honor Society. Angel has contributed much of her time helping out in the concession stands at Highland Park and has also helped out at the circus at the Expo Center. After graduation, Angel plans to attend college and major in criminal justice with the emphasis on forensic investigations and pursue a minor in sociology. She intends to use her degree to become a forensic criminologist. At this time, Angel Michelle Allison.
Good afternoon, everyone. First, I'd like to welcome parents, family, friends, school faculty, and my fellow graduates as we celebrate the end of our high school years. When I was first told I had to write a speech, I was so worried because I had no idea what I would say. So I did what I've done for the past 4 years. I procrastinated until I had no choice but to figure something out and then stayed up until 4 a.m. trying to finish it. Now that might not seem like the brightest thing to do, but it got me this far. The most important thing to me are the people in my life. Every person you meet teaches you something, some more than others. Now I could just stand up here today and give you all advice and talk about the future, but instead I'd like to thank a few people who have taught me something significant that has helped me get where I am today. The first person I want to thank is my mom. She has taught me to be the kind of person you can rely on. She's always been there for me, and I know I can count on her no matter what. My mom is one of the sweetest people you'll ever meet, and she's exactly the kind of woman I hope to be one day. The next person I'd like to thank is my dad. He's taught me to put other people before myself to a certain extent. He's went above and beyond for me and my brother. He always makes sure we have what we need, but he also tries to give us what we want. He drove me 13 hours to Detroit for a concert just because he knew it would mean the world to me. And it did. Thanks, Dad. The last two people I'd like to thank are a couple of my favorite teachers, Mr. Maysberger, or as most people call him, Mays, and Ms. Walton. Mays always made his class interesting, whether he tried to or not. I think I had him for at least 4 classes in the past 2 years. And I actually changed my major from, or my minor, from sociology to psychology, and his class helped me make that decision. And Ms. Walton taught me way more than the required curriculum for her class. She taught me to find a job I'll be happy doing every day. Ms. Walton is one of the nicest, bravest people I've ever met. She cares about her students' well-being just as much as she does their grades, and she's not afraid to stand up for them. You can tell just by the way she acts that she loves her job. Any student would be lucky to have Mays or Ms. Walton as their teacher. Now, a lot of my friends know that I'm a huge fan of Eminem, so as I near the end of my speech, I'm going to use one of his quotes. He said, "The truth is, you don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. Life is a crazy ride and nothing is guaranteed. So when you leave today, leave with the knowledge that in the end, the people in your life are more important than anything else. They could be here one day and gone the next. Appreciate them while you can." Thank you.
Thank you, Angel. At this time, it is my great pleasure to introduce to you our keynote speaker, Ms. Teresa Walton. Terry Walton is a 1972 graduate of Highland Park High School. She holds dual degrees from Washburn University in theater and English. Prior to her teaching career, she was a professional musician, actor, and director, and she is a member of Topeka Civic Theater's Hall of Fame. She was the director and owner of the Garlow Daycare Home, the Potwin Learning Center Preschool, Camp Imagine Summer Camp, and Imagine Ensemble Drama Camp. As a member of USD 501, Terry spent 1 year at Lafayette Elementary, 2 years as a substitute teacher, 9 years at Eisenhower Middle School, and 12 years at Highland Park High School as both assistant band director and language arts teacher. She received the district award for first year teacher of the year, founded and sponsored the Parody Club for our LGBTQ students, the Anime Club, and the Louder Than a Bomb Slam Poetry Team. She is also the editor of Straight from the Pipes Literary Magazine and is a three-time recipient of Topeka Public Schools Foundation grants. Finally, she is the assistant drama director, has been the music director for more than 20 years, and was proud to be a part of the group that represented the Scots Theater in Scotland. But most of all, she is our Mrs. Walton. Please receive Ms. Terry Walton.
Thank you, Dr. New, and thank you very much for the invitation. When I sat in where you're sitting now, I never ever thought that I'd be standing here speaking into this microphone, but it is the greatest honor I've ever had. Thank you all for having me. The first Highland Park graduation I attended, I was a Highland Belle. I wore a very ugly dress. I made it myself. It was hideous. The second, I was in Scott Singers, and Scott Singers sang a song that I wrote. I thought I was really cool. It was at the Municipal Auditorium because of rain. Oh, by the way, that's the Performing Arts Center to you. I was to play a recorder solo, a little flute thing. And so I wore this really cool ring on this finger. Only the ring was too tight and turned my finger huge and purple, and I had to leave graduation and go to the hospital and have it cut off. Totally embarrassing. My senior year, I graduated at Mower Bowl at Washburn University. I got my diploma, and then I walked the wrong direction and had to go, excuse me, while all my classmates said, "Way to go, Walton." A terrible start. However, the things I did and the things that I learned at Highland Park High School made me who I am today. If you ask these students right here to explain Highland Park, they'll tell you we're a family. It's always been that way. The first graduating class in 1917, they were a family too. And they were integrated. It's always been that way. Highland Park never spent a segregated day. Something to be proud of. And we've always been a family. And I come from a Highland Park family. My father was a brick mason, and he helped to build the building where you all and I went to school. He also ran a dog kennel on California Avenue and provided a Scotty dog mascot back when we were the Scotties. My parents were both graduates of the class of 1954. My mother was a cheerleader and a drum major, and my dad was a major jock. I tell my students I bleed plaid blood. I was in Scott Singers, as I said, and I had the lead in the musical my senior year, and I loved high school. Sorry. My favorite teacher was, of course, my English teacher, Mrs. Bobby Monteith. She remained one of my heroes until she died, and then I was lucky enough and honored enough to sing at her funeral. When I started school, we had a dress code. Girls had to wear a dress every day. A dress. Every day. In the middle of my high school career, however, that got protested and we got rid of it. Thank the Lord. I started as a Scotty, I ended as a Scotsman, and now I'm proud to be a Scot. Now, I'm so grateful to be ending my working career back at Highland Park. I wanted to come and give back to Highland Park. And it's an honor to give back. I highly recommend it to all of you. Doesn't matter whether you're giving back to your family or your friends, your neighborhood, or your school. Giving back is great. It feels really good. I know for most of you, all you want to do is get the heck out of here. So did I. I could not wait to move to Lawrence and begin my hippie life. Yeah. And I did. But rejoining this family has been one of the greatest joys of my working life. And it's because I'm back in the family. While at Highland Park, I've gone through some really tough times. I nearly died twice, once from blood clots. Mr. Keekafer nearly killed me. Another from congestive heart failure, when Mr. Keekafer wouldn't allow me to die. I lost my father, and this last year I lost my husband. And through it all, my Highland Park family has been there for me. Mr. Cushenberry held me like a little girl the day that I lost my father. I work with the best group of teachers in the district. Yes. And they are always supportive, even Mr. Maceburger. But best of all have been you students. You visited me in the hospital, made me get well cards, flocked me twice, bought me gifts and cakes, decorated my house for Christmas, gave me hugs, a list too long to mention. I belong to a huge and wonderful family. And so do you. And now as you leave here, remember, you'll always belong to this family. I'm taking a long driving trip this summer. And as I drive thousands of miles, I'll be stopping to visit my Highland Park family in every state I go through. I'll see former students and staff and alumni everywhere I go. There are successful people doing amazing things all over the United States. It's true, you can get there from here. Believe it. Go out there and do it. This 100th anniversary year will be filled with family reunions. People will come from everywhere to be here and to see family. I can't wait. And though it may be the last thing you want to hear right now, this is the reason why. Because it's great to be a Scot. It's like Lenny. It's like Lenny says to George, "'Cause you got me, and I got you. That's who gives a hoot in hell about us." We're all in this together. We are family. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Walton. I would now like to introduce to you Mr. Patrick Woods. He is the president of the Board of Education. He lives in Topeka with his wife, Anna, who is a Topeka Public Schools teacher, and their two children, Zen and Itzel. When not spending time with his family, Mr. Woods works as Director of Talent Management and Diversity at West Star Energy in Topeka. Mr. Woods received a Bachelor of Arts degree in Political Science and History with a minor in Spanish from Friends University in Wichita, Kansas. He also received his Oral Proficiency Certification of Advanced Plus in Spanish Language from Kansas State University, as well as certificates for Foreign Exchange Studies, which he completed at La Salle University in Cancun, Mexico, and at the University of Barcelona in Barcelona, Spain. He received his master's degree in public administration from the University of Kansas, and in that program he received the commendation of most outstanding graduate in public administration. So at this time I present to you Mr. Patrick Woods, the president of the Topeka Public Schools Board of Education, who is bringing greetings and congratulations on behalf of the board. Mr. Woods.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Dr. New, for that very warm introduction, and thank you for everything that you've done on behalf of the students who we have seated before us today. We are here to celebrate you, class of 2016, and what you've accomplished. In just a few short moments, you are all going to turn your tassels together in unison and become forever graduates of high school and alumni of the Topeka Public Schools. With the knowledge you've gained, along with the skills and the talents that you've developed, you'll pursue post-secondary education, enter the world of work, or service in the military, equipped to change our world for the better. Now that we all know that this day wouldn't be possible without the countless hours of support from friends, family, and mentors along the way. So we want to acknowledge the parents, the aunts, the uncles, friends, any mentors, teachers as well, who've played a part in your being here today. So students, if you would join me in a round of applause for all of the folks who are here to support you today. It's very important that we recognize those who supported you and helped you get here. We on the board are here now to recognize you, the key ingredient to everything that we're seeing seated before us, all of the success today. We've built this institution, free and universal public education, because we know that our society and our way of life are only sustainable if we ensure an environment where all people are welcomed and where all talents are utilized. History is littered with peoples and societies that fail to leverage the talents of all of the people that they would call their own. That's why we have the Topeka Public Schools and the Institution of Public Education, and it served us very well as a society. We're more prosperous, we're more innovative, we're more resilient, and more fair than we would be without it. However, I'm optimistic today about our future, not simply because of our grand institution, it's wonderful, but really I'm optimistic because of you. As I look out on your faces, graduates, I see a generation that's already learned to leverage the richness of our diversity to meet collective challenges, benefiting from everybody's talents, regardless of their differences. The differences of birth and the differences of circumstance, they really have no bearing on your potential. You've proved yourself capable of rejecting the world's low expectations over the course of 13 academic years by leveraging our diversity to make us stronger collectively. Our district is stronger because you've used our diversity to gain access to new cultures and new languages for learning. Our city is stronger economically because you make us a more agile and capable workforce that can work across cultural boundaries. And we're stronger as a community because we have this vehicle to advance mutual understanding and the common good. So in addition to celebrating you, graduates, we on the board are issuing a charge to you, because along with the credential that you've earned, you now have a great responsibility, and that's to commit your talents to this work of building our community so that every single individual can realize their talents, realize their full potential. Further, it's your duty, I would argue, to take what you've learned about yourselves through your experience in our district and shape your own path in pursuit of this community building, refusing to be divined by others in the world's preconceived and narrow opinions about your abilities. So while our challenges as a community are new and they're different than anything we've ever seen, the remedies with which we will address them are not new, they're old. Our hard-won commitment to a community in which every single person can develop their talents, leveraging our diversity and embracing all humanity, these things are old, they're not new. And your presence here today is evidence of your ability to do this over the course of 13 academic years. Now, for a group of folks sitting out in the on the floor who are 18-year-olds, that's the vast majority of your life. You've mastered this. You've done it very well. So it's for these reasons that I believe, and this is a dramatic statement, but I fully believe it, I believe that our last best hope for a brighter future is you. My colleagues and I on the board are hopeful and optimistic for the future because of you. With your talents, you'll help our community and our state and our nation remain more prosperous, more innovative, more resilient, more fair, and just plain better. So on behalf of the Topeka Public Schools Board of Education, congratulations, we love you, best wishes on your journey, and God bless you.
Thank you, Mr. Woods. At this time, I would also like to acknowledge the board members who are with us today. And as I read their names, I would like for them to stand so that you can acknowledge them. We're so happy to have with us Dr. Michael Morrison, who is Vice President of the Board. Ms. Janelle Johnson. Ms. Nancy Kirk. Dr. Peg McCarthy. Dr. Scott Mickelson. And Mr. John Williams. These individuals volunteer their time, intellect, and committed focus on making sure that all students in Topeka Public Schools receive the highest quality public education possible. So let's give them all another round of applause. Our last speaker is Ms. LaShaughnessy Davis, president of the senior class. She will come at this time to share parting words with you, her fellow seniors. As well as being president of the senior class, LaShaughnessy has been involved in many sports, clubs, and organizations, and many other activities, including basketball, tennis, track and field, student council, Spirit Club, and FBLA. With her involvement in athletics, she has lettered in basketball, tennis, and track. LaShaughnessy has also volunteered much of her time in the community with the Rock the Block program. LaShaughnessy's future plans involve attending Washburn University Law School to become a lawyer in criminal justice and to work on either racial justice or sex crimes. She then plans to become a judge for the court, followed by becoming a Kansas Supreme Court judge, then becoming a judge on the U.S. Supreme Court. And if you know LaShaughnessy, there's no doubt that she will accomplish those goals. The final assignment that I'd like to give her is she's going to have to train somebody to be the spirit leader at Highland Park High School. At this time, LaShaughnessy Tiara Davis.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, Highland Park graduates and parents of the graduates. The 100th year. We are the 100th year to move on to the next stage in our lives. We didn't lose anybody this year. That in itself is amazing. We're all 100% here. Now, my mama said, I gotta do this speech right, so here we go. As a freshman, we all took that walk into a new environment, nervous, anxious of what the future would be like. By law, we are required to take this journey, regardless if we like it or not, and I didn't like it. I didn't like it at all. The very thought of having to be nice and make friends appalled me. But I did, but I did. Shout out to Carly in the background right there, yep. Mm-hmm. We all did, some of us more than others. Our class wasn't the typical high school show. Everyone knew everyone. It didn't matter that one was in theater and the other was a basketball player, or one sang in the choir and hung out with the football players. Every one of us took a step out there to gain something, whether it be to excel in academics or to try new things or to make new friends. Most of us lost the things we thought would be here by this time, but that's okay. It's okay. You didn't die. I would just like to say that I'm blessed. We all are blessed. For everyone who doubted us because we go to Highland Park, makes this so much more sweeter. No matter what it looks like on the outside, we all know what goes down on the inside. We know what it goes like in the walls of the school, and we didn't need nobody else to tell us what it was like. Our class beat a lot of statistics. We weren't supposed to make it this far. We weren't supposed to be sitting here listening to me. We definitely weren't supposed to be receiving our diplomas. It's just not supposed to happen. We are all going our separate ways, breaking off to what we dream. And I just want to say, I believe. If you take nothing else from me, just know that I believe in you. I believed in all of us. And Nike said it best, just do it. Whenever I went to an event, I believed in us. Whether I had some great kids to cheer on our football team, or I sat at a theater performance enjoying them singing and dancing, Heather King, you know what it is, or I painted my face for our basketball team and we made it all the way to state, and that was just the most exciting moment in my life. Thank y'all for giving me that opportunity. Even going out so far to sit in events I didn't understand, but because I show love for everyone, I went and did what I do best. I cheered. And I loved every single moment of it. Before I conclude, I just want to say to anyone who's holding a grudge or is angry or upset at anything I ever did to hurt you personally, I'm sorry. I don't want someone to carry a weight over something that I did for the rest of their lives, and anyone who knows me that I say what I say and it is what it is. Sorry. Whether you're angry at me or someone else, forgive them. Forgive me. I used to dislike the majority of you, but look at God. Here we are, right? Thank you. Thank you to the staff of Highland Park for giving me this opportunity. Thank you to the students, for being my classmates, for being my friends, for making me laugh, for brightening my days. Yeah. Thank you to my best friend, Camille. You kept me out of a lot of trouble, and I appreciate you for it. I love you, and I'm gonna miss you when you leave. Thank you, Miss Richardson. You became family to me, and I love you. You also kept me out of a lot of trouble. Thank you to my mom. You dealt with me for 18 years, and then some. You put up with all my fits and my mood swings and my teenager behavior and all the good stuff. Thank you for being at my side when I was cheering on everybody, for picking everybody else up when I couldn't do it myself. Thank you, coaches. I forgot that. Thank you to all the coaches. And last but not least, thank you, God. Couldn't be here without you 100%. I'm out.
Thank you, LaShaughnessy. Before we present diplomas to the 100th graduating class of Highland Park High School, we will have a serenade to the students by the Highland Park High School Concert Choir. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday.
So
Thank you, Dr. Katindo and the Highland Park High School Concert Choir under the direction of Dr. Katindo and with the accompaniment of Ms. Roslin. Thank you so much. As we prepare to present diplomas to the 100th graduating class of Highland Park High School, the class of 2016, I'd like for you all to know that among these 205 young people, we have graduates who have accumulated composite amount of over $600,000 in scholarships. And to our recognition, this is a record for Highland Park High School students. As we have each year, we ask that all parents and well-wishers remain in the stands. We have professional photographers who will be here to capture this event for you and your student. Students will approach the stage from the left side, receive their diploma cover and shake hands, pause for their personal photograph, and then exit the stage on the right. So ushers, at this time, please escort the 100th graduating class of Highland Park High School, the class of 2016, to the podium to receive their diplomas.
Angel Michelle Allison, National Honor Society, top 10%. Melody Alvarado. Lee Vashon Amato. Elton Ruben Arteaga. Jennifer Bonelli Astorga. Scott Burton Aubert. Cassandra Sue Bailey. Shaquan Ball. Joelle Love Barfield, National Honor Society, top 10%. Amari Kiera Barksdale. Armad Akil Battle. Asha Dene Battle. Bryn Mariah Booker. Damian Alexander Bradley, top 20%. Xavier Desmonnier Brown. Javian Julie Bollocks. Casey Lynn Burt. Okay. Dejaniqua Briante Bush. Leslie Caldera. Elijah John Calhoun. Mark Anthony Calloway. Keyshawn Latrice Cameron. Nicholas Gene Campbell, top 10%. Nina Patrice Carter, Link Crew. You don't have it. Okay. Kenya Castillo Reyes. No card. Alan Castillo Puente. Abraham Sadio Moreno. Jordan Terrell Cheney. Artasia Renee Conley. Colton James Connor. William Corona. Kayla Marie Cortez.
Do you have your card?
Will Crawford. Angel Cruz Garcia. Lisa Marie Cunningham. LaShaughnessy Tiara Davis. Jessica De La Rosa. Miles Anias Dean. Tanya Lizeth Diaz. Caden Anthony Plecchio Dominguez. Brandon Lee Duval. Way to go. Harold Melvin Emmanuel. Jorge Luis Encinas. Anai Espino. Latasha Marie Evans. Job Fernald Yoshihara. Carly Diane Flowers. Okay, Ahmad Kishan James Fox. Deshaun Amir Fox. Jamontez Kyrell Fulton. Lexi Marcella Fuque.
Stefan Tashan Gales. Sonia Elolia Garcia. Jesus Ladio Gonzalez. Remy Nicole Goodwin, top 20%. Tayana Cynthia Gordon. Sean Michael Google. Zora Jacques Kimberly Green. Cynthia Annette Gross. Top 20%. Cesar Edgardo Guerra Garcia, top 20%. Benedict Giovanni Guerra Ariola, National Honor Society, top 10% AVID. Ajane Chavry Diane Gumby, Student Association President, Link Crew, AVID. Oscar Javier Gutierrez. Tavier Damon Henderson. Joshua Lee Early Hofer. Alicia Lynn Howard. Cheyenne Cherie Hubbard, Avid, top 20%. Daniel Elijahwan Amir Heiston. Christopher Morris James Jr., top 20%. Wayne Kenneth Jasper Jr. Danae Ariana Jones. Dantasia Shantice Jones, National Honor Society, top 10%. Marcus Earl Jones. Premier Asire Jones, Senior Class Secretary, Link Crew. Quintasia Chanel Jones, top 20%. Darian Jamal Keeling. Malik Jaquez Keith.
Garen Scott Keekafer, my boy.
Heather Murray King, National Honor Society, top 10%. Bradley Dylan Chose, top 20%. Sabrina Leanne Kuhn, Avid, top 10%. Sydney James Kuhn. Betsy Genesis Lopez. Israel Lopez. Maria Fernanda Lopez. Tianche Denise Love. Cynthia Lizeth Macias. Brenda Maciel, National Honor Society, top 10%. Jasmine Maris. Clarissa Marin. Julissa Martinez, Quill and Scroll, top 10%. Michelle Martinez, National Honor Society, top 20%. Veronica Jasmine Martinez. Robert David Martin Foster. Asiana Erica McCracken, National Honor Society, top 10%, Link Crew, AVID, Student Association Vice President. Brendan Alexander McGinnis, AVID. Reginald Leroy McKinney. Quatavia Therese McNeil, Quill and Scroll, top 20%. Corinne Elizabeth McWilliams, National Honor Society, top 10%. Erica Deschelle Metters. Marisa Eunice Miller. Elijah Terry Minson, top 20%. Mary Elizabeth Monell. Nathaniel Dean Murithy, Link Crew, top 10%. Christina Isamar Negrete. Jacinta Santana Negrete. Emily Ann Novak, Journalism. Cecilia Nuno, National Honor Society, top 10%.
Jalil Lord Osby. Jose Francisco Paredes. Roberto Ivan Paredes. Eduardo Reese Paz. Jalia Nicole Peppers. Daniela Iranza Peraza Munoz. Dylan Quinez.
Janae Fosti Alisa Rainey, Senior Class Vice President, Link Crew. Javier Antonio Ramirez. Manuel Alejandra Ramos. Paula Yasmin Ramos, National Honor Society, Top 10%, Link Crew, AVID. Edgar Omar Rascon. Elijah James Ray. Daquan Jermaine Rayton. Taisha Nicole Rayton. Benjamin Isaac Reed. Ivory Xavier Reyes. Daisha Risby. National Honor Society, Top 10%, Quill and Scroll. Jose Rivera, National Honor Society, Top 10%, Link Crew. Caitlin Marie Robbins. Shamari Renee Roberson. Sierra LaVon Roberts. William Curtis Robertson. Alexander Rodriguez. Edgar Omar Rodriguez. Paulina Magdiel Rodriguez, Journalism. Megan Arizona Rose. Hey, Megan. Jordan Keith Ross. Isaiah Cole Ryan. Watson Folk Samuelson. Eric Sanchez. Camille Nicole Sanders, National Honor Society, top 10%. Evangelist Orlando Sandoval. Jessica Janet Silva, National Honor Society, Link Crew, top 20%, and AVID. Asa Elise Simpson. Devontae Dominique Smith. Manuel Soto Carrillo, National Honor Society, top 10%, AVID. Brittany Ajene Soul. James Robert Spence. Denicia DeShante Stano. Deterian Marquez Steele. Link Crew. What did you say? Alicia Renee Stewart Davis. DeMarcus Dean Swift. William Porter Swopes. Jamie Telez, Link Crew. Joshea Annette Terry. Donette Sky Thomas. Hunter Leon Thoman. Raphael Michael Tristan. Andreas Julian Vega. Harley Ray Vincent Haler. Quillen Scroll, top 20%. Darion Kiata Wade, top 20%. Earl Leon Wallace III. Brady Lee Weaver. Byron Eugene Wheeler. Marquise D'Angelo White, Link Crew. Clayton Thomas Williams, Quillen Scroll. Deshaun Montrell Williams, Lake Crew. Jessica Lynn Williams. Nakira Deshay Williams. Lyric Monet Wolford. Elena Marguerite Woodward, Lake Crew. Robert Patrick Wright. You made it. Devon Darnell Wonder.
Could we give one more round of applause to the 100th graduating class of Highland Park High School, the class of 2016. As we approach the end of this celebration, I want to encourage each of you to continue to be 100%. You are the ones who made it 100%. Others started with you this school year, but did not choose to finish strong. They are not here today, but you are 100%. So keep going, keep reaching for your goals, keep doing what you know to do, even though the person to your right or to your left might get off track. If you stay focused, you can be the one to light their way. You can do it. You have already proven that, 100%. So as you leave today, celebrate safely, because we love you. Be all you were born to be, because we are depending on you. Stay strong and keep your courage, because we need your leadership. And no matter where you go or what you do, always remember how great it is to be a member of the 100th graduating class of Highland Park High School, because it's great to be a Scott. So at this time, class of 2016, please shift your tassels over to the left side. You are now officially graduated. If you want, you can toss your mortarboard, and congratulations.